The fact that everything changes, paradise, the doors are flung open and the gates of a hellfire are tightened and are closed. And then the devils are tied up and are chained. A person has so many opportunities for a person to do good. But it's important, my dear brother and sister, for a person to think about it from now. Don't have all of your eggs in one basket and expect somehow, like you speak to a lot of brothers and sisters, they're doing a lot of things which are not pleasing to their creator, and you say, Yahi, Ramadan's next week. Less than a week. Ramadan is next week. And they say, don't worry, I'm going to stop doing it the day before. That's the ending. If a person has such an intention before they know it, because they haven't been able to withdraw themselves, yani with ample time, a lot of the time, they'll return back to it very easily. You need to make a firm intention from now, if you haven't already made one. What are your goals? What are your targets for this Ramadan? And you need to start from now. When the month of Ramadan enters, they can focus. Their mind is not occupied with doing other things. Their mind is focused. You're completely focused on doing what you're supposed to do during this month. This is once every year. And Allahu A'lam knows, as we say all the time, this is more like a cliche type of statement that we don't know if we're going to make the next Ramadan. The point is, regardless whether we're going to make it or not, a person needs to make sure that this Ramadan, have this intention from now, that is going to be better than all of your previous Ramadans. If you're alive next year, alhamdulillah, that's a bonus. That's a bonus. Regardless whether you're alive or not, but try to have an intention from now that this Ramadan is going to be special. You're now about to raise the bar. That I'm going to do something that the likes that I've never ever done before. And